You are Lord over it all. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And we worship you, God. We come to adore you and to speak your name over all the earth. For you are good and greatly to be praised. We take this moment to pray our prayer of adoration and worship. Set the atmosphere for God to hear what you're going to ask. Declare his glory. So I ask you, what words do you use to describe God? Text those tonight. And as you're struggling to figure out how you pray this prayer of adoration, listen and look at how others declare his glory. When you think about God's goodness, what words come to mind? When you think about how awesome God is, what adjectives can describe God's glory in your life? Text those and let's spend some moment in prayers of adoration as Kaya praise team sings softly, "Oh, come, let us adore him." If you want to lead a prayer, this microphone's open. You don't have to be ordained. You don't have to be a pastor. You can come and lead a prayer of adoration.
For this evening. Thank you, Papa God. You are so worthy to be praised. We worship you. We adore you. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for who you are. Thank you for allowing us to be here this evening. Thank you for our lives. Thank you for the person sitting next to us. Thank you, Lord, for Christ. We thank you for the Holy Spirit dwelling in us, Lord. We thank you for your love, your heart. Thank you, Papa God. You are so worthy to be praised. We worship you. We honor you. We exalt your name. We adore you, Lord. We say thank you, Jesus. We say thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for waking us up. Thank you for bringing us here today. Thank you for tonight. Thank you for who you are. We thank you that you love us, that you adore us. We ask for forgiveness, Papa God. We ask you to forgive our sins. The ones that we knew we created or did, or even the ones that we didn't even realize we committed. The thoughts, the deeds, the actions, forgive us, Lord. The hurt, the grudges that we hold, forgive us, Papa. Help us to let it go. We just honor you. We just say thank you. We ask for your protection. We ask for your guidance, Lord. We ask for strength and endurance to continue to put one foot in front of the other, to continue to move forward even when we feel tired. For you say, when we are weak, we should say we are strong. So we say we are strong. We say thank you for your strength, Lord. Thank you for just this evening. Thank you, Lord, for just continuing to move us forward in life. And we just pray for your protection, your guidance, your continued love, Lord, and favor in Jesus' precious name. For you said in John that whatever we ask for, we have not because we haven't asked for, but when we ask in Jesus' name, you know, you will give to us, Lord. So we thank you in Jesus' name.
Over the sanctuary tonight, oh God. We come to bless your holy name, God. We come to thank you, God, because you're an awesome God. We come to praise your name, oh God, because you're patient with us, oh God. We come to thank you, God, because you haven't given up on us yet, oh God. We thank you, God, because we can call upon your name, and whenever we call upon your name, you're right there, oh God. We come tonight just to honor and to adore you, God. Because you are King of Kings, O God. Because you are Lord of Lords, O God. Because you're sovereign, O God. Because you're high and lifted up, O God. Because you are the great I am, O God. Because, O God, without you, God, we wouldn't be here tonight, O God. We come to just praise your holy name, O God. We thank you, God, for the opportunity to just be who we are, Lord, and know that you accept us and that you love us, O God. For knowing, O God, that you're patient with us, O God. For knowing, oh God, that your arms are wide enough and strong enough to hold us, oh God, even when we feel like we're falling apart, oh God, and yet your hands are big enough, oh God, to rest even over our heads, to protect us from all the hurt, harm, and danger, God. We come to say thank you tonight. Thank you for being Jehovah, God. Thank you, for God, for showing up in the nick of time tonight, oh God. Thank you, God, for answering prayers we didn't even know how to pray to you tonight, oh God. Thank you, God, for even knowing how to interpret the moanings and the groanings and the tears that fall from our eyes tonight, oh God. Thank you, God, because we know you. We know that there is hope, dear Jesus. Thank you, God, that yet when we were even yet in our sins, God, you sent your son to die for our sins, oh God. That we wouldn't have to live in the mess of our sins, oh God, but if we would confess them and receive you into our hearts, oh God, that we could be safe and secure in your arms, oh God. We come tonight as believers, Lord Jesus, because we've had an encounter with you tonight, oh God. We come tonight, oh God, because your name is sacred and holy tonight, oh God. We come tonight, oh God, because you're the most precious person that we know, oh God. Who can we call unto, oh God, in that midnight hour? Who can we call out to, oh God, when our friends aren't around us, oh God? Who can we call out to, God, except for you, Jesus, when nobody understands what we're going through, Lord? And so tonight, we thank you, God. We say thank you all around this sanctuary, God, because you loved us enough, oh God. You loved us beyond even any love that we've ever received from anybody else, oh God. God, you've held us in your arms and you've protected us and you've held us together, oh God, and you've not let us go, oh God. That God, even when we find ourselves walking through the valley of the shadow of death, you're right there with us, oh God. Tonight, oh God, that gives me great joy and great excitement, oh God, because I don't know how I'm going to solve it. I might not know how I'm going to figure it all out, but I know you know the answer, oh God. I know that you know the plans that you have for my life, oh God. I know, God, that you know the number of hairs that are on my head tonight, oh God. And so I don't have to fear anything. God, we come to bless your holy name. We come, oh God, because you're righteous. We come tonight, oh God, because you're awesome, oh God. We come tonight because you go above and beyond anything we could ever say about you tonight, oh God. That's why we say hallelujah in this place tonight, oh God. Hallelujah, because it's the best way for us to say, Lord, we love you. Lord, we honor you. Lord, we magnify your name on high, oh God. God, we open ourselves to your love tonight. God, we open ourselves to your healing tonight. God, we open ourselves to your forgiveness tonight, oh God. And we bless your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I love you forever. I love you forever. I love you forever.
Things that's clear in scripture is whenever a man or woman was standing in the presence and realized they were in the atmosphere with God, they were mindful of how unworthy they were. For how can you dwell in God's presence and not be convicted of your own unrighteousness? The psalmist said, when I consider the heavens and the stars that God has made, who am I that God is mindful of me? Isaiah said that when he caught a glimpse of God's glory, woe is me, for I am undone and unclean. That there are moments when the Lord leads us to a moment of conviction by the power of his Holy Spirit, that we might lay aside the weights and the sins of our lives. The Bible teaches us in 1 John chapter 1, verse 9, that if we confess our sins, God is faithful and just to forgive us of all our unrighteousness. So I'm going to lead us in a prayer of confession of sins. We're going to do a few things that I hope you'll join in with me. You'll allow the Holy Spirit to convict your heart of that which God wants you to let go of tonight. That you'll join us in a posture of prayer that shows that repentance. Some of you may want to kneel. Some may come to the altar. I want to ask a few of our ministers and deacons. The Bible says that there's power in having someone pray with you as you confess your sins. This is not judgment. This is not someone trying to get in your business. But if you just need that touch of someone to pray with you as you release something out of your life, a habit, an iniquity, a sin, that there are those who will be praying for God to give you the strength. It's one thing to be convicted and feel bad. It's another to embrace the Holy Spirit's power to not do it again. I want you to bow with me in prayer. We stand before you, O loving and merciful God, knowing that we are unworthy. That you told us in the book of Isaiah that all of our righteousness is as filthy rags in your sight. And God, we acknowledge that even when we have tried our best, we have fallen short. And we acknowledge that there are moments when we didn't even try our best. Knowingly, willingly, and voluntarily abandoned, rejected, and ignored what you told us to do. And sometimes, oh God, we've borne the burden of our sinful choices. We come to you asking now that by the power of your Holy Spirit, you would speak to me in this moment of the sins that I must confess in your presence. Not only the sins that I have committed, but oh God, the sins I've got on my agenda for tomorrow. The things I've already convinced myself I'm going to do regardless. The things the devil has convinced me I can't stop because that's just who I am. Lord, and I need you not only to forgive me according to your word, But to allow that Holy Spirit to give me the strength tonight to lay something down. To lay someone down. To cast something out of the desire of my heart. To remove a taste from my mouth. To break a habit of my flesh. And Lord, not just the obvious things, but those deep-rooted things that continue to give rise and fertilize sinful desires in my life. That insecurity, that bitterness, that abuse in my spirit. Whatever it is in me, oh God, that allows sin to take hold and root, convict me now by your Holy Spirit, that I may lay it down at the altar. We don't come in pretending that we've got it all together, but we acknowledge that some of us fake Christianity real well. I've got my Bible, I know how to get to church, and I can sit in a pew and act like everybody else. But oh God, you know and I know where my heart is not right. You know and I know where my life is misaligned. And I'm grateful that your mercy has kept some stuff from getting out. That by your mercies, I didn't reap everything I sowed. By your mercy, some things that should have happened never did. But Lord, I don't want to play with mercy any longer. I don't want to cheapen your grace and just think that I can keep on living the way I'm living, doing what I'm doing, and you'll just keep being merciful and merciful and merciful. No, God, I don't want to play with you like that. Hear what the Lord says to some brother, some sister tonight. Do you really want to be holy? Give me a clean heart. Renew a right spirit in me. Don't take your Holy Spirit away. Restore to me the joy of my salvation. Let the Holy Spirit do his work right now. I'm going to ask our ministers to stand in the aisle. Let's not come to the altar. Someone doesn't want to come down front and be seen. Stand in the aisles. If you want to come lay before the Lord personally and privately, the altar's here. And if you're still texting, now what sins are we laying down? Name it and lay it down at the altar. If it's fornication, if it's lying, if it's lust, if it's deceitfulness, if it's bitterness, the good news is that someone else needs to know that they can confess it just like you, that if you've got the boldness to put it out before God, they can too. God cannot heal what you won't reveal. Confess your sins openly to the Lord in this our time of repentance before the Lord our God.
To show someone the way.
In the great hymn, "It Is Well With My Soul," there's a third verse that is so powerful. And I want you to hear the words. "My sin, oh, this glorious thought, my sin, not in part but in whole, is nailed to the cross, and I bear it no more. It is well with my soul." The hymn writer understood that when we confess our sins to the Lord, they are nailed to the cross of Calvary. And it's a burden and a weight that Satan cannot make us bear any longer. With a sincere heart, if you lay something before the Lord in repentance, the Lord removes that stain of guilt and shame, and you don't have to bear it anymore. Now, it doesn't mean you won't be tempted with it anymore or struggle with it anymore. But you can stand firm in the words of Paul that I am more than a conqueror, and that there's no temptation taken me but such as is common to all people. And God, with every temptation, makes a way out. And your way out is to pray your way through. Lord, we thank you that the death of Jesus Christ and his shed blood is more powerful than my sin. That wherever sin abounds, grace abounds that much more. And that you always have more grace than I have sin. And I know it's been a weakness. I know it's been something that's been in me for a while. But I declare with my lips right now, I am forgiven. Can you just say that with me? I am forgiven. No, you don't believe that. Because the devil just whispered in your ear, oh yeah, watch what I do tomorrow. I am forgiven. You are not a slave to sin. You are not destined to repeat that which is unrighteous. So God, I pray that you give me the strength now to fight this battle one moment, one temptation, one day, one night at a time. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hey, God. Hey, God. oh God. God, if there's nothing else that we thank you for, it said in Jesus Christ we are forgiven. Don't let the devil convince you that simply because you have a long track record and you still desire certain things and wrestle with certain things that you are not forgiven. Your forgiveness has nothing to do with your ability, but the fact that Jesus Christ died on the cross as full and final payment for everything you could ever do in this life. His death for you was so awesome and so miraculous that the devil convinces you that can't be all it takes. But that's how good God is. That while we were yet sinners, Christ died for the ungodly. That any man or any woman who is in Christ is a new creature. Wait, here's the shout. Old things have passed away, and all things become new. Everything prior to 8:35 tonight has passed away. And everything else is new. So God, now we thank you because you've done some great things even when we were not worthy. We thank you for ways you've made, doors you've opened, resources you've sent, friends who were there when we needed it, strangers who had no reason to care about us, you used them to bless us. I thank you for things my neighbor doesn't even know I have. I bless you for things my family doesn't even know you did. I thank you for little things. I stood in front of a closet and had to choose what outfit I was going to wear. I thank you for little things. That you gave me strength when I didn't think I'd make it through that. When I saw it coming down the road, I thought it would kill me. And now it's miles behind me. And I'm still here. And God, I thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I just want to thank you, Lord. In this time of Thanksgiving, I want you to think about where God has shown his hand in your life recently. And somebody needs to be encouraged by that, so go on and text that. Where has God shown his hand in your world recently? And let's just thank him in this moment of prayer. Thank you. Listen, we're not done yet, but I just need you to hear the testimony of praise. We just broke that app with all the thanksgiving for folk that were texting in of how good God has been. Somebody knows God's been good. God's been good. The Lord is good, and he's greatly to be praised. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Come on, can you just help me bless him? Thank you, Lord.
I just want to thank. I just want to thank. I just want to thank you, Lord.
Before we transition, Brandon, I just want to praise you. Forever and ever. Yeah, right there.
Forever.
Come on, and ever. Come on, come on.
And ever. And ever.
And ever.
Somebody say for all.
For all. You've done.
You've done.
For me.
For me.
Come on, blessings.
Blessings and glory.
Blessings and glory.
And honor.
And honor,
they all belong to you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
For blessing.
For blessing me.
Come on.
Just want to praise you.
Just want to praise you.
Forever.
Forever.
And ever.
And ever.
And ever.
And
one more time.
Oh, just want to praise.
Just want to praise.
I just want to praise you.
May be seated. We're almost done. We're almost done. Isn't it good to talk to God? Now, you may not have known this, but for 45 minutes, you've been praying, and we ain't asked God for nothing yet. That flips it, because so often we go to prayer, we just bow down and say, Lord, do this, fix this, make this better. Then we get up and go. And we've spent 45 minutes in His presence, and just now getting the place where we make our supplications. Oh, I love the word of God when it promises me in Philippians 4:6, be anxious for nothing, but in all things with prayer and supplication and thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds. This is what the Lord says. When your heart is stayed on me and you adore me and confess your sins and thank me, He says, I want to give you the desires of your heart. We have a God who wants to answer prayer. And the good news is, whatever that request is you make right now, the Lord says, your eyes haven't even seen how good I want to be. Because He is a God that goes exceedingly and abundantly above all that we could ask or think. For somebody, that prayer request, for someone else, that prayer request over your life, you just want someone to touch and agree in prayer with you. Now, I'm pulling all my prayer warriors, all my pulse team, my deacons, come to the altar. And there'll be people down here with you. And if you want to come, this is a great time to just get up from your seat, walk down, and have someone touch and agree with you. As a matter of fact, that's what you ought to do. You ought to have someone come and pray with you. And so, as I lead this prayer, I'm going to ask our deacons, our ministers, and our prayer team if they would come to the altar. And as the Lord would lead you, after I lead us collectively, won't you come down and let somebody touch and agree in prayer with you as they're making their way. Lord, we come now to just ask you for what we stand in need of. You said in your word that we could come boldly to your throne to find grace and mercy in our time of need. So we acknowledge our need. We acknowledge that we can't do this by ourselves. We acknowledge that we need you to speak to us and grant us discernment. You said in your word, if we ask for wisdom, you would always give us wisdom. Somebody's got a difficult decision to make, God, and they need you to open their eyes. They need you to speak clearly above and beyond other voices. God, I'm not looking for other people to speak to me. I need you to speak to my heart. Speak to my heart, Holy Spirit. Give me your holy word. We stand now to pray for others as well. There's somebody in our life who needs you, like right now. They need you to show up right now. And we believe that the prayers we make in this house can make a difference around the world. So we ask you to hear our prayer, O Lord. Incline your ear to us and grant us your peace. If you want to come forward, and if there's somebody you want us to intercede for in prayer, you can text that name for people we're praying for other than ourselves. And the altar is open now for all who would come, and just have somebody pray with you. Just give it a try. Don't be so proud and so bold. Come and let somebody touch and agree. The Bible says that you ought to call together the elders of the church to pray with you, that wherever two or three touch and agree, God will make it so. Touch and agree tonight. Come on, let's pray with you. Thank you.
to do. Lead me, oh Lord.
Lord, how we thank and bless you for some time in prayer, for an opportunity to draw away from the world and to stand in your presence, to adore you, to confess our sins, to thank you and to ask for what we stand in need of. Now, Lord, we stand on the assurance of the promise you gave to Solomon that when he built the temple and opened the doors of the house of God, you promised him you would be attentive to prayers made in your house. So we know that you've heard us, and we trust you to answer in your own way. And we believe that whatever you're going to do is better than what we asked for. So we trust you, and we bless you, and we thank you. Now, Lord, I pray for everyone that's in this place tonight that this would not be a one-time, one-day-a-year experience, but that you would teach us to do this on the side of our beds. Teach us to do this in our private prayer closets. Teach us to do this in our offices at work, in our cars on the beltway. The Lord wants you to know the power you felt tonight is not limited to the walls of this church. You can feel this way every day if you start on your knees in prayer. So here's a promise we make, God. This won't be the last time you hear from us tonight. And if by your grace and mercy we awaken tomorrow, we'll do it again. Be with us as we get ready to leave this place of prayer, knowing that we never leave a place where we can pray. For wherever we are, we can call on the name of our God. And we bless you and we praise you. And we end these prayers with a mighty word that says, let it be so. Amen, amen, and amen. Come on, let's stand and we lift our voices in our final song. Praise him, Jesus, blessed Savior. He's worthy to be praised. And as we sing that, let's leave in the grace and the joy of God. For this, our time of prayer. Come on, praise him.
Praise him. Praise him.
Come on and praise him.
Praise him. Praise him.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Blessed Savior.
Savior.
He's worthy.
He's worthy.
Rising of the sun.
From the rising of the sun.
Until the going down. T-shirts downstairs. Go in the grace of God, and may the grace of God go with you. Amen, amen, and amen. We'll see you all in December.
Hope of salvation.